Have you ever wished to discover how to help your employees with their occupational stress in a mindful approach? What if there is a way to building a productive and supportive environment for your employees that leads you to influence the organizational culture positively? Well, this is your invitation to join us to Mindful Leader Talk, a podcast on the effects of mindfulness as a secular practice on occupational stress and organizational culture. The information presented in this podcast is general. It is intended for educational and entertainment purposes only. It should be never used to diagnose, prescribe medical or psychological conditions, or replace a physician. And it is not intended to prevent, treat, or cure such conditions or substitute for mental care, preventive health care, counseling, or therapy from or a physical or mental health professional. Thank you for listening and blessings. Blessings and welcome to the Mindful Leader Talk podcast, Mindfully Coping with Occupational Stress. I am Maria Weiss, an organizational leadership psychologist, consultant, trainer, coach, and a full-time magician. Did you know if there are effects of mindfulness on the human cognitive, nervous, and immune systems? Stay there to find answers in today's podcast. I cannot begin to talk about the effects of mindfulness on the cognitive system, the nervous system, and the immune system without first refreshing our memory about these vital systems for us. The cognitive system is the source of all mental processes and products arising from complex neural activity in the brain. A cognitive system is a group of interactive and interrelated processes that act according to a set of rules to form a unified whole. Its job is to execute how information is treated and manipulated through thoughts, knowledge, and memory within the brain. It is how we understand, plan, decide, solve problems, analyze, synthesize, evaluate, and judge information after perceiving it. Still, it is also dictates our actions and behaviors. The nervous system is the body's central control, regulation, and communication system. It is the center of all mental activity, including thinking, learning, and memory. The immune system is a complex network of cells, tissues, and organs that fight infection, harmful substances, germs, and cellular changes to protect the physical body against disease. By assimilating that definition of the cognitive, nervous, and immune system, we can realize that the practice of mindfulness is implicit within all these systems. Based on scientific research, there are four mechanisms by which we can have evidence of the effects produced by mindfulness practices. There is the regulation of attention, the awakening of the body, emotional regulation, and the change of self-perspective. Theoretical accounts describe mindfulness practices such as focused attention, self-compassion, self-awareness, physical impulse control, clarity of thought, and emotional control. Studies related to the effects of mindfulness practices in how humans show that mindfulness practices can provide new solutions to current problems and handle potential future issues that results from demographic and technological changes by which all humans begin so through today. An article produced by the Department of Health and Human Services of the United States called Mindfulness Meditation and the Immune System, a systematic review of randomized controlled trials, confirmed mindfulness practices as a mental core trainer for developing a mindful daily life. The effects of mindfulness meditation on the immune system were measured considering parameters with a specific focus on outcomes. For instance, circulated and stimulated inflammatory proteins, transcription factors cells and gene expressions, immune cell count, aging immune cells, and antibody response. The findings suggest the possible effects of mindfulness meditation on specific markers of inflammation, cell-mediated immunity, and biological aging. Thus, mindfulness meditation can be healthy for the immune system. In addition, it can help improve self-reported measures of disease symptomatology. The effects that mindfulness meditation has on the biological mechanism underlying aging. That's awesome. Through a psychological process called intention of self-attention, mindfulness practices can help us to make conscious decisions and be present in a particular moment. As a result, we can become aware of what is happening within us, with focused attention to what it is, without presenting a judgment or qualification of what is happening to us at that precise moment. And so, we can reduce problems related to our physical, mental, and emotional health. This is pretty much it for this episode. Thank you for listening and stay in tune for the next topics in 2 weeks. Occupational stress, the physical body, and mindfulness from the chiropractic's perspective. If you have any questions, concerns, or comments, please visit my website www.embiasconsulting.com or send me an email to maria@embiasconsulting.com. This is the Mindful Leader Talk, a podcast on the effects of mindfulness as a secular practice on occupational stress and organizational culture. Feel free to invite to listen or share this podcast. Stay in tune for all coming episodes to building profitable organizations driven by the well-being of their employees and therefore our society. In the meantime, please stay safe. Blessings!